What's going on, guys, and welcome to Who to Sign For. Now, in this series, I'm giving you my recommendations on what players to sign for a specific team in career mode. But before we go on, I will say that the signings you'll see aren't designed to be realistic, and the player ratings and potentials of the players may vary depending on what database you're using and how they perform for you during the season. Obviously, you don't have to follow the tips. This is really just a set of guidelines to give you a hand if you're stuck for ideas and want some suggestions on what players you could sign for a certain club. This is mainly aimed at those of you out there who may be new to the game and just need a little bit of advice, or for those of you out there who want a few recommendations on what players you could sign for a team that you may be using in career mode this year. So yes, in today's episode of Who to Sign For, guys, we're going to take a look at RB Leipzig of the Bundesliga in Germany. And I'll say this right now before we start the episode off. This is definitely one of the teams to use if you already want the groundwork done for you. Now, they start off with a budget of around £57 million. With wage budget alteration, you're looking more likely to be around £62 to £63 million. And their objectives in the first season are very, very simple. They've got to finish in the top four in the Champions League, which is more than doable. Right now in real life, so I'm recording this commentary, they're the closest threat to Bayern Munich. Reached a round of 16 in the DFB Pokal, and also reached the quarterfinals of the Champions League. That's the toughest objective of the three, as they've never done that before in the club's history, I believe. But the domestic aims are pretty simple, and even that European aim should be achievable in the first season, so long as you don't get a really tough first knockout round tie. Now, as you take a look at RB Leipzig's side, they normally line up in a 4-2-2-2 in the game, and it's a very good side. And the one thing you'll notice as I show you the squad here and run you through the squad hub is that it is one of the most youthful sides in the game. It is one of the youngest sides in FIFA 20. It is so youthful, and there is so much talent here. It's actually ridiculous. Like, it genuinely is. It's almost like the RB Leipzig board have been playing career mode in real life. It's crazy how young their side is. And as you'll notice, I go through the list, so many players have got potential tags of 81 or higher. Everyone seems to be in their 20s. In fact, there's only one player that's over the age of 30, and that's your backup goalkeeper. Your second oldest player is 29. You've only got one player in their 30s. The second oldest is Galaxy, the number one, at 29 years old. It is absolutely ridiculous how much young talent this team has got all across the board, everywhere in their team. They've got two players that are currently loaned in. That's Sheik and Angelino, the left back. And they've got several players that have their deals that come the end of the year as well. Personally speaking, I wouldn't give any of these guys contracts here. They're all 18 years old, and I'd let them all go come the end of the season. But yeah, every single player here, or I should say most of the players here, are in their 20s and really, really good young talents as well. So this RB Leipzig career mode, it's not really about who you signed for it, it's who you don't sell. And my recommendation is keep as many of those players as possible, because there is very little reason to sell any of them when most of them are, again, in their early 20s and still have plenty of room to grow. But if you are going to make a new signing of, again, around £60 million, my recommendation would be a new striker. And there are four players here that I think would be fantastic. Anthony Martial, Lautaro Martinez, who sadly we couldn't get as Inter Milan wouldn't negotiate with us, Marcus Rashford, or Milik of Napoli. Now, of course, you're probably sitting there thinking, why would you get a new striker? You've got Timo Werner, who's one of the best young strikers in the game, and Yusuf Poulsen, that's in his mid-20s and still very good as well. Well, you can improve on Yusuf Poulsen, and you can get someone younger as well. And my recommendation mainly would be Lautaro Martinez. He's my number one target. However, you might not be able to get hold of him, as Inter Milan don't have much depth in the striker role when you start your career mode off. But either Anthony Martial or Marcus Rashford would be really good options. Now, Marcus Rashford has striker as his secondary position, but as we know, he can play up top with no problem whatsoever, or as an inside forward on the left. And you can get Rashford for around £43 to £45 million. We agreed a deal of £43 million with Ed Woodward, and as you can see here, we negotiated a pretty cheap contract in today's footballing world to bring in the 83 rated 21 year old. He's one of the best young inside forward slash strikers on the game. Again, already at 83 overall and just 21 years old, and this guy has got 89 potential as well. Is it 88 or 89? I think it's 89, but regardless, with dynamic potential, he can get into the 90s as well, and Rashford would be a fantastic addition to your RB Leipzig side. You can either have him playing as an LAM, or a inside left winger, if you will, in Borussia Dortmund, in RB Leipzig's 4-2-2-2, or you can play him where I would play him, up top alongside Timo Werner. The choice is yours, really. But again, in my personal opinion, I would play him up top as an out-and-out striker alongside Werner. The guy's absolutely rapid with 94 sprint speed and 89 acceleration as well. He's very agile, got good balance. He's got 5-star skill moves and a freestyle weak foot as well with high stamina too. Physically, all across the board, he's a really solid player. His technicals are great. He's 6'1", Marcus Rashford, as well. So not a little lad. That's my height, 6'1". And yeah, got some fantastic stats, both technically, mentally, and also physically as well. He's an improvement on Yusuf Poulsen. He's 2 ratings higher, and he's 4 years younger with better potential as well. Plus, he's more versatile too. So yeah, I definitely recommend Rashford, no doubt about it. Again, I think it's 89 potential. It might be 88. With dynamic potential and also player training as well, he can get into the 90s. He would be a solid signing for your RB Leipzig side. And again, you don't really need to sign anyone in the first season. There's so much young talent here, but if you are going to sign someone, again, I would go for a striker. Either Rashford, Martial or Martinez would be great options, as would Milik. But again, I think if you're going to choose one of the Manchester United boys, I would go with Marcus Rashford. But as for sales with RB Leipzig, you don't really need to sell anyone in the first season. You've already got a really, really solid young team. But the one player I wouldn't be against selling is your first choice left back. That's Marcel Halstenberg. He's a very decent player, 81 overall and 27 years old. But whilst he is 27 years old, you can get younger and you can get better. And that's the theme of most of these episodes here, looking for younger players that are also higher rated as well. You can get around 22 to 22.5 million pounds for Halstenberg. That's the deal we agreed to sell him. And we've got Angelino, who's here on loan. He's a young talent, only 22 years old. And again, there are players that are younger and better on my shortlist here. You've got Grimaldo of Benfica, Lucas Digne of Everton, Tagliafico of Ajax, Gaia of Valencia, and also Juan Bernat of Paris Saint-Germain as well. Any of these 5 left-backs here to replace Halstenberg would be superb. They're all younger, and they're also all higher rated as well. But my recommendation, the cream of the crop, if you will, out of these left-backs here, would be Alejandro Grimaldo of Benfica, the young Spanish left-back who is just 23 years old, so 4 years younger than Halstenberg, but 2 ratings higher at 83 overall, and has 87 potential as well. The bad news with Grimaldo is that since he is the best and the joint youngest as well, you are going to have to spend the most amount of money to get him. You're probably paying around £37.5 to £40 million to get him. That's the deal we agreed with Benfica. So it's £13 million over his current market valuation. So it's a very big transfer fee to get hold of him. But he is one of the best young left backs in the game. Again, just 23 years old. So 4 years younger than Halstenberg. And again, 2 ratings higher with 87 potential as well. He'll be your starting left back for all the years you're at the Red Bull Arena. So, yeah, we signed Grimaldo on a, was it a 4-year deal or a 5-year deal? £40,000 a week. So not actually that expensive a contract for one of the best young left-backs in the game. But again, like with Poulsen replacing him with Rashford, we've got someone younger and better. And like with Halstenberg, with Grimaldo, we've got someone younger and better. His top stat is stamina at 90. His second highest stat is acceleration, which is 86 as well. So this guy is very, very quick with high medium work rates. He can bomb up and down the pitch all game long with that 90 stamina with 84 sprints. Speed, 86 acceleration, and again, the guy's technical stats are really good as well. Defensively, he's very solid, and he also offers you something when going forward as well, and can be a good offensive threat when bombing up that left-hand side. So yeah, Grimaldo would be a great player to replace Halstenberg. You don't need to do it. Halstenberg is more than good enough in the first season at 81 overall and 27 years old, but if you want to sign someone other than one of the strikers, then he'd be a good option to replace with a younger and better player like Alejandro Grimaldo. So those are the 2 signings we made, Grimaldo and Marcus Rashford. And I did try and swap out the only 30-plus-year-old goalkeeper at my club here. That's Philipp Schauner, who is 33 years old. I believe you can't sell him in the first season, as I think he's just signed for the club. I think I might be wrong. But I tried to swap him out of the club, but unfortunately couldn't have managed to do that. But I did manage to agree a deal with Bayern Munich of just £1 million for their young goalkeeper, Frutal, as well. Again, I tried to swap him out with 4 different clubs here, but unfortunately, none of the clubs wanted to get hold of the 33-year-old. They're looking for younger players, not older players. So in the end, I just decided to give up and go after the young German goalkeeper. But yeah, Frutal from Bayern Munich, he actually plays for their reserve side in the game. So you shouldn't have to pay over his valuation to get hold of him. We paid £1 million for him. His wage is obviously going to be dirt cheap as he's very low rated. However, he's got 82 potential, which means that when it's all said and done, he can become a very solid solid backup goalkeeper for your bench, and with dynamic potential could possibly even become your number one. He's not going to take Peter Galaxy's place in the first team, obviously not. He's not going to take Mvogo's place on the bench, obviously not. But as a reserve goalkeeper, someone to, you know, grow and get better as the years go by, it's always nice to have a player like that in your reserves, a good young talent, and he becomes our fourth choice goalkeeper for the season. So yeah, in the end, we just signed three players. Frutal, the young goalkeeper there with 82 potential, not too noteworthy, but also Marcus Rashford coming in for £43 million and Grimaldo for £40 million, and just a one sale in the end as well. That was Halstenberg for 22.5 million pounds. So yeah, £83 million spent on Rashford and Grimaldo. If you include the goalkeeper Frutal, it's £84 million in total, but some good young talent coming into this RB Leipzig side. Two of those players in Rashford and Grimaldo going straight into the first 11 to replace the older players in Yusuf Poulsen up top and Halstenberg, who of course we sold at left back as well. The question was, could we achieve success in our first season with RB Leipzig and hit those objectives with our very young and very talented youthful RB Leipzig team? Well, as you could see, we did indeed in the Bundesliga. We had a very successful year in the top tier of German football, finishing in third place. So managed to finish in the top four, which is what, of course, the board asked of us in our first season. 4 points behind the eventual winners, Bayern Munich, and two behind Borussia Dortmund as well. So it wasn't, you know, it wasn't a second place finish and right behind Bayern Munich, but finishing in the top four was all that mattered, and that's what we were able to do. But as for our progress in the DFB Pokal, we ended up winning it. We won the German Cup in our first season. We beat Hoffenheim by 3-1 in the final at the Olympiastadion and knocked out Bayern Munich on our way to winning the German Cup in our first season as well. So all we were asked to do was reach the round of 16, and we ended up winning the whole thing. So silver in the cabinet come the end of the first season. Very successful indeed. However, it was a failure in Europe. We hit two of our objectives. Well, hit one objective, succeeded the other, but did fail the European objective. We were knocked out by Liverpool, the holders of the Champions League, in the round of 16. We were asked to reach the quarterfinals, and sadly were beaten by Jurgen Klopp's Liverpool one round prior to that. But no shame in going out against one of the best sides, if not the best side in the world, and the holders of the Champions League too. So yeah, in Europe it was unfortunately a failure, no matter how you look at it, but domestically, what a fantastic season for RB Leipzig. Third place finish, finishing in a Champions League spot like the board asked of us to do, and of course being just 4 points behind Bayern Munich whilst also winning the German Cup and having silverware in the cabinet come the end of the season. This was a really successful first season with RB Leipzig. Unfortunately, they sold Tyler Adams, a very good young American talent, midway through the season in January. You might notice I show this from time to time in these episodes. Basically, when there's a sale that happens in January, I've had no involvement in that. The AI at times just decides to do it for whatever reason, I don't know. But yeah, I never get any involvement in that or any warning. It just happens naturally as I simulate from start to finish. But yeah, Adams got sold. I think it was Galatasaray he went to. But regardless, it was still a very successful first season for RB Leipzig as well. You see, Frutal grew 4 ratings in his first season, despite not playing a single game. Grimaldo grew 2 ratings to 85 overall, and scored 5 goals in his first season as well in 45 appearances too. So very impressive debut year from the Spaniard there. And again, as I run you through the team, you can see every single player has grown in rating in the first season, including Rashford, who had an incredible first season at the Red Bull Arena. 21 goals and 5 assists in 29 Bundesliga games, and grew 2 ratings to 85 overall and just 22 years old. This kid's off to an amazing start in life in the Bundesliga. Fantastic first year for Rashford. 26 in 41 in all competitions. What a start he had at his first year at RB Leipzig. But yeah, the whole team was progressing in the first season and growing ratings, because again, this is one of the best teams you can do for an RTG, where the work is sort of already done for you, because most of these players here are players that are already at the club. They're all good young talents with lots of potential to get better for the future as well. It's a really fun team to use, RB Leipzig. They've just got such amazing young talent, so many amazing young players. Real stadium in the game, nice kits as well. And if you can cope with being labelled as the most hated team in Germany, which unfortunately is what they are known as, then yeah, you'll have a really fun career mode with RB Leipzig. They're a super fun team to use with all the young talent they've got. But that was today's episode of You Design For, guys. A big thank you for watching. If you have enjoyed it, and if you did enjoy today's episode, then please do drop a like. Much love to you all. Have a fantastic day, and I will see you for the next episode of Who To Sign For, where I'll probably make more signings than in this episode very soon.